Hello and welcome to this month's Scriptcase webinar. My name is Jamie Yates and I am your host today. This week I will be showing you how to be adding an alternative menu into your project. So that's pretty much what you're seeing right now on your screen. And this is the menu we will be adding. I've added into this the dashboard basically, just some basic demo apps just to show off that you can, you know, that this menu is actually quite nice. We can close that up, open it back up again, and add our applications in there. Now I've added the security group in there, the change password, and just the demo application and form, as well as then we have down here the log off button, which then logs off for you. And we can, of course, customize that much further. And we've added some extra content in here, which is grabbing that from the database. So let's go ahead and make a start with this and start off with the project. Now, in the last month, we had gone ahead and created the styles project where we had styles from these applications. So we have here the colored buttons, the select input, the check radio. If you didn't see that last month, go ahead, check it out, download it, because it will be the start of this project. We will be using the same samples database that is available when you generate the samples template that is within Scriptcase. And so we will be using that same database within this project, and you will be also wanting that if you are wanting to recreate this. So I'm going to go ahead and I have the security folder here. Now I've already gone ahead and deleted everything. Now if you start off with that project, you will still have that folder. So I just went ahead and added that folder just for the sake of it. So go ahead, delete that folder if you're starting that project. Ignore my task up there, it's just a demo task really. So once you've deleted that folder, I'm going to go ahead and start off by creating a new folder. And I'm going to call that part two. And now the reason why I've now deleted the security applications, or why we've all deleted them, is because we are going to also go ahead and modify the applications. So if I come here to Application Express Edit, and we are going to remove security from all of our applications. So by doing this, we can really quickly apply a real quick change to all of our applications, and then we just generate our source and voila, everything is applied without having to spend hours, I mean literally hours, going through each application, making the change, checking a tab, checking another tab, and driving yourself crazy doing that. There's really no need for that sort of thing within a Scriptcase. We can just click, 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 and we're done, which is really cool. Okay, so now within part two, I'm going to start off by creating some very basic applications, and I'll start off here with the grid application, which we've seen, and I'm also going to generate the form that I had there. Okay, so that will become available in a moment. So I will choose here, first of all, the customers table, and that will then select all the fields for me, and I'll check this little box here, and it will also generate the form customers for me, which will be related to this grid data, and also provide me straight away the add, edit, or CRUD features that we want for our grid. Okay, so that's going to go ahead and generate that now. Now you don't see the form there. The form has also been generated, and we can see that by just scrolling to the right here and clicking the add new button, and there is the form. Okay, so there's nothing special with that. It's really just to have these available within the menu application that we will be creating. Okay, so then the next application I have there is just a basic dashboard that I've added in there. So if I come here and choose now the dashboard application, I'm just going to leave the name as dashboard, create that, and really quickly you have that generated also. And I'm just going to whack that over here, add another link widget, and we can just choose one of any of these applications. Okay, I'm going to choose one of these control applications, and that is then going to come over here to the right hand side. And on the initial one, I will add one of the grid applications. Okay, so within your own dashboard, of course, you're going to go ahead and you're going to customize that to your heart's content and show whatever you like there. Okay, so I'm just actually just creating these. So I have these basically ready within the menu application. And then you have a dashboard there. You have some general links and some content basically to what's going on. So here I've actually gone with the form customers. Let's change that to a grid. Grid customers, save that, run that again, and that should now then be the grid. There we go. Okay, so that's going to do for the dashboard, and then we now need to start off with the menu. So for the menu, we are using Font Awesome icons, so you will need to download them from Font Awesome. Let me just adjust here the browser, and we have then also the URLs here. So I'm coming here to Font Awesome using 5.15. We just download them here. And for the menu, we are using here, as I don't exactly know how to pronounce this, Azure-Med React Pro Sidebar. Okay, so this sidebar is actually designed to use within a React component, and we can install it there with Yum and everything else, but we're really not going to be doing that today within Scriptcase. We really don't need to. And we can apply the same sort of workaround, you could say, within just about any other Git resource that we have available that we may want to apply to our own projects within Scriptcase. So we just come here, we download then also the zip file for this. Once we've downloaded that, we can then go ahead and add them to our libraries in a moment. So looking here at the sidebar menu, you can see it has quite a bit of functionality. Of course, you can go ahead and add some of these. You have all of the usage information down here, and you will have to change that accordingly because, of course, we are using just straight PHP and no React components at all. But we have all the information there, and you can actually follow that along. Now, I have personally gone ahead and used this menu within my own project and made some really nice customizations to it, and like I say, it's actually really nice to use. Okay, so we need to start off then, first of all, coming here to tools and external libraries. Now, the external libraries are basically components, you could say, that we can just attach to our project. And if you've watched the last webinar, you'll see that we already have added one here. Now, if I go ahead and edit that, we'll see that it's basically a replica of the samples a library that is available here. So if I close that again, this one here, so that was the samples, and it was just renamed, or save as, renamed, and then we attached it here to the project. Okay, so basically for this project, I want to do the same thing again. So I want to add it to, first of all, to the public library, so that I can use it within any project that I create. So I'm going to create here a public library first of all. And I'll scroll down here, and between all of my libraries that I have here, and where is it? React menu. There we go. We have it here. React menu. Okay, so if I edit that, I now have the empty folder structure. So now I can click the upload, and then I can just drag and drop my files, or essentially the zip files, straight here into the container or the box here. And then once they're displayed, I just go OK and leave the extract the zip file at the end, and that will then extract the folders that are compressed within that. And now these are then usable within our own project. Now the alternative to adding the entire library here, like we see here for the React menu that we've just downloaded from here, I've downloaded the whole thing and uploaded the entire library here. Now we don't really have to do that all the time, so what we can really do is just we can create our own folders. So in this case, I'm going to do this as a demonstration. If I then create a new folder here and I call it, say, sidebar, for instance, I'll create that, and then I can enter this folder and I'll create a new file, and I'll call this one, say, sidebar.js, create that. And then if I click here on the edit icon, I can change the name of that. And then to actually add content, I need to click it. And then I can then paste the functions that I've then copied from the React Sidebar Pro website directly into the JS file. And then for the project, we also need the CSS. So then I'll call that sidebar.css and create that. And again, just click it to open it, and then I can just paste in the CSS or the required CSS styling for this component, save that, and then I can just exit this folder, and then I could basically do the same thing here with Font Awesome or any other project that I want to incorporate within this. So that is basically my external library ready, and that is now within the public folder. So I could now just come here to the React menu and use the library as I had it there. It was actually used there. So if I come back down again, it should now be deselected. So if I could now use this library as it is, or I could save it as, which is what I'm going to do. I'm going to save it within the project, and I'm just going to call it menu. And that way it's basically customized just for this project. And that way I can keep those ones separate as basically template, you could say. Okay, so once I have that there, I can then choose to use the library and then save the project libraries. Okay, so right now, of course, it's copying all those folders there, and generally I wouldn't want those, but it doesn't matter for this demonstration. I'm just gonna leave them there. And then we can go ahead and close that. And then within my part 2 folder, I'm gonna go ahead and create a new application. And this time I will create the blank application, and I'll go blank underscore menu, and I will go create. Okay, so we have now our blank application. Of course, I run this and it's just blank, it's absolutely nothing. But the power of actually being able to use this application within our project basically then allows us then to code whatever we want and still retain all of the features, capabilities, and power of Scriptcase within our project. Okay, so here, the first thing I can do is I can go ahead and, I'm just gonna copy and paste this here, is use an SQL select, and request first of all the user login, the username, the group, and insert that data within the application here. So now this is the only one I'm going to add this way, and the next one I'm going to add as a method, which I'll do shortly. But first of all, let's go ahead and start off with the coding for this application. So I need to open and close my tags so that then we have then we can actually paste HTML in here. And I'll start here with the header tags, so all the way down to the start of the body. Okay, so in the head here, I'm first of all calling here Bootstrap. Okay, so I'm also using Bootstrap within this, and you know, it allows us then of course to apply more within the application. And here we have then the library for the menu, and Font Awesome we're also adding here via the CDN, and we also have here the CSS style sheet available for the menu, which is also within the project. So we could change these CDNs if we wanted to use the project. I'll leave them as they are. It's really just either way, really depends on your project and so forth, but having them locally of course provides some advantages, I think. So okay, so the next thing of course within here, the React Pro menu, we have here all of the content on how to create this application. So if we come here, we have then here the live preview that we can check out, and of course from the live preview we can inspect that, and yeah, we can just copy and paste the content from there, or we can actually find it within the React app website. So one of the two, that's available on both sides. So I've already prepared that for us and replicated basically what we need here to build that into our application. So I'm going to continue then with a copy and paste here at the moment. So at the end of our page, we have then first of all of our scripts and the end of our body. So here I'm finishing that with a div. It's okay for the time being. It will not be read when we finish. So then below that, we're adding here all of the jQuery scripts, Popper min.js and Bootstrap min.js. And here we have then the sidebar JS from the project. Now, I do believe we had that up here. No, so that's Font Awesome icons. Here we are also adding Font Awesome icons, so meaning we can actually remove that one if we wanted to. I will leave them both there for the time being. You can make your own choice. And at the bottom of this, okay, so at the bottom of this, we want to close up, first of all, our navigation and everything, and our footer. In fact, this is in the wrong spot. Let me adjust that. That comes here, okay. And that is then the footer section of our navigation. So here we have then app login, which will then come to the new security that we will build. And we have then also targeting the iframe A. So we will see why shortly, because at the moment we can actually add further menus to this and, you know, make this a bit more powerful. Okay, so then we have then an icon displayed, and then we have the rest of the menu. So I'm just gonna go ahead and copy paste the rest of it. It's really a lot quicker that way. So I come up here to the body and then like so. Okay, so from the top down, we have all of our styling sheets and so on, and these JavaScript all down the bottom. And then we start off here with the iframe, with our initial menu section. Here we have the header and the user image. Okay, so here I'm just using an image from, again, GitHub, a user image there. And we can replace that if you wanted to. And then here I'm going to echo the username, and here the group, which we are actually getting from here. Okay, so here we're selecting our database, grabbing the login, the username, and also the description of the group. So if it's an admin group or so forth, or whatever group you have available, then that will then both be displayed here. Okay, then you also have the online. Of course, you can customize this so it displays online or not. I just left that as it is. And below that, then we have the date. Okay, so Below that, we have then the actual menu section. So then we start off with the basic link. So if I go ahead and run that now, that should pretty much be working already. So we need here, first of all, our variables. And we have here the count all client, count users, user login. So at the moment, we only have here the user login, which is actually from up here. And for that, of course, we need to build the security. The group is here, but we do not have our count all users yet. So let's go ahead and add that before we actually go ahead and customize that further. So what we want to do then is basically add a method into this so that we can basically expand this application or further. So I come here to programming, left-hand side, methods and new method. We can actually create the doCounts method that we have there. So I'll create doCounts, and I'll just copy that name, save that. And now if I come here to new method, we will then create that specific method. And then within that, we can then just perform a very basic select count from customers. And that's going to go ahead and then count all of our customers and then display that within our form. So that's one way of doing it. Of course, we could add then libraries as well and, you know, really expand that further, because we have here the internal libraries, which are super powerful also. And of course, a quicker way is using methods, allows you to compartmentalize your data. Okay, so now we're actually also doing the counts here, which is here for the two variables that are being requested. But we really don't need them to be requested when we start the application. So we come here to the left side, application, and global variable. And here we're going to choose out and save that. Okay, because we don't need them when we open the application. We actually need them after we've opened the application. So if I go ahead and run that, and now I just have there the admin, password manager, and that then opens up the menu and only requests then the admin or user variable. We have then also here the customer count displayed, and we have then all of our applications built into this new menu that we can use. Now we still need to add our security, so let's go ahead and add that really quickly. I'll just come here to the root folder, come up here to modules, security, and we'll create new, and we'll create the group security really quickly again. Now delete the previous tables. Now I like to have protect logged users. I think sometimes it's also quite annoying, so I don't know. Maybe somebody let me know what they think in the comments. That'd be really good of that. Okay, so then we continue. And then from here, from this point, we can then further customize the security module that we're going to enable. So here, the encryption, what we want to choose, 256, 512, or MD5. You know, I prefer the SHA-512, even though maybe anything's breakable these days. And then we have what to do when the session expires. So we do want to choose here if we want to do nothing, or if you want to redirect the user back to the login page, or maybe even display a message and then redirect them. Let's just redirect them. And then we have the other options here that we can choose whatever we like. We have also the option to generate a menu. Now, we do now already have the blank menu, which we just generated, this one here. Okay. But what I actually want to do is create another menu. So I'm going to create menu application, and I'm going to choose a standard menu. And then we can further continue to customize all of our settings here. Now, we do want to use a login template because we have the libraries enabled. And we can see here the login 602, and then click Next. Okay, so fill in our user data. So I'll leave it as admin, and then next. So when you actually open this project and you want to log into it, the username is admin. And of course, you can then change that within the database if you want to. And we then simply generate our source code, and all of our security applications will now be generated just like that. We can run it really quickly, and we have our login page. Okay, so if I come here then and go admin, and then submit that, it will now take me now to the default menu is created. Okay, so I don't really want that. Okay, so what I actually do want is I want to open the other menu. So I'm going to select this menu that's available from security, and I'm going to move it to the root folder. Okay, in fact, I'll move it to part two. Okay, so basically, I really like moving it out of security because I actually delete the security quite often, and I'm rather quite happy to regenerate the security and have it update my descriptions that I add into my applications, any other data that I actually want to capture here, all of that is added then automatically into the database. So by regenerating the security, it will choose your current applications, gather the data, and select it into, well, add, insert it into your database. So if you generate them afterwards, and of course it's not going to do that, you manually need to do that. And if you know already, it is a little painful. So that is the quickest and easiest way to do that. So we now have here our app menu, and I want to then open that. And I'm going to just choose the Gleam Dark Blue. It's much the nicest menu. And we have here the security options already. I don't want any of these, so I'm just going to choose all of those and delete them. Okay. And then here I can then maybe add the option to choose the menu. And then here I'll just go blank underscore menu. And of course we can customize that further, whether we have alternative menu options here or not, because in general you may want to have an about, or you know, any other pages that you want to have here, then you may want to have them here and have then the menu separately. So I'm just going to add it in here. Let's then go ahead, save that, and then run that. Okay, so then we have our menu application, and we then have the menu here. That should actually be updating with, oh, we have no pages attached though. So let's add some pages here so we have something linked to these. So I'll link this one here, for instance, to the blank drag and drop. The terms, let's link that also to something here. For instance, the select input, and run that. And then we have our menu with the extra options, whatever you want in there. And we can just select that menu and open that. Now, when we log in now, of course, I'll come here to security and log in. When I now log in, it will take me straight away to the menu. It'll take me straight away here to the menu. So I could, of course, change that so it takes me directly to this menu. And to do that, then I would need to open up the app login and come here to the events. And we see here the events that are loaded, for instance, here on validate. So once the user clicks the login button, we can see here what happens next. So we have here the remember me validate method. That should be back here. So I'll come here, PHP method. But now really we want to change what happens once the user logs in. So here the remember me validate will be no good really. So we want to check here on the on validate success, what happens after the user has logged in. And for that we have here the method SC validate success. So if we check here the SC validate success, and we have here an SQL select, so it's grabbing here the user data, which applications they can use and so forth. And at the bottom here, we can see here the SC redirect method that is used, or the macro. We have all the macros here to the right hand side, which are really powerful and really useful to use. Do check them out. Just click here on the question mark, and it will take you straight here to the macros help and give you any information you may need on how to use them. So they're super powerful. And within that, you will find here the SC redirect. And with that, once the user's logged in and everything's been confirmed, all the applications been gathered, what they can do, we then redirect them basically to the app menu. Okay, so you may want them to redirect then to the menu that we have here, so this original menu, this top one, or you may want them redirected to this menu. So in that case, we would then need to change here the redirect. So what I'll do is I will add another one, comment this one out, and then we'll call this one blanket underscore menu. And then now when I actually log in, instead of taking me to that first menu, it will take me to the new menu. Okay, so that is then the choice there. Now I do personally like the idea of connecting that to an alternative menu, so having the first menu run first, this one, and then placing that here within the layout and actually see how that works out. So that's something I've actually done for my own project. Maybe within the webinar I will show the participants. So if you're actually within the webinar, you will actually see how we can apply that as an alternative option to use the menu within your application. Okay, so that's all the applications we will be building this week. I hope you have enjoyed this session. And of course, if you have any questions or doubts, you can post them within the comments, send me an email, or just, you know, contact support, whatever feels good for you. So stay well, be safe, and catch you next time. And thank you very much for watching.